Okay. Is that okay?
This whole what?
The meeting.
No.
Go ahead, sorry.
My name is Chris.
Yeah, I saw you. Well, I saw briefly on your Twitter.
Yeah.
So far. So I've been trying to find out the process of spreading the marketing platform.
Okay.
And I mean, there's been a few challenges, but still, when I look at the markets, small market analysis, has big potential.
Okay. So
Okay. Where I can have teachers,
okay,
who do mostly tutoring,
okay,
being able to find not only the students' parents,
okay,
but also the parents to be able to find a suitable teacher.
Okay. So when you say when you say teacher, you mean a home tutor
or a I've been talking to the teachers, and the way it came about, I have a son who's 9. He just started one. So I've been helping him with the homework, but also with the schedule and everything. Good. I mean, he still wants to get homework every day, even on Saturdays.
I'm not a big fan of homework at that age, but that's just stupid. I think kids need to be kids.
They need to be kids. But the homework is not really that tough. Maybe 30 to 45 minutes a day gets done.
Some kids can get overwhelmed with
that. Yeah, definitely.
But yeah, go ahead.
From that point on, I was like, you know, if I do want, how would I go about it?
Okay.
And then I started, I have a cousin who's a teacher. Then I talked to her, I started, you know, asking around if I can find help, maybe when you get to P2 or P3, just to get a feeling of how it goes. But it was difficult to find one. And every time you find one, it's like, how can I check this person is, you know, a match or what I need? So that's when the idea came about. I was thinking about starting a tech company, but it's like, you know what, there's a gap, you know. And I talked to teachers, and this is where the light bulb really went on, is that all the teachers, most of the teachers, due to the low salaries, they all do a different extra on the side. So I was like, if all the tutors do all the tutoring on the side, it's not centralized, there's no, they don't have a CV, they can't tell you what parents are like, hey, I've been doing this for 2-3 years, I'm asking for this much, you know? You can't justify that money. And the more I talked to them, the more I saw all the problems they had. They said, we don't have a contract with this parent. I can work with a parent for a month. And then after the month, we have a small problem or disagreement, but they simply say, I don't need the services.
Yeah.
And they don't pay me. I don't have a teacher now, there's no contract.
Yeah.
And I can't go to somebody's house. So on the parent side, it's the same problem that I encountered. You can't check somebody's reputation, or at least know how good they are.
Yeah.
So I was like, you know what, why not create an online marketplace for teachers?
Yeah.
You know, gather all the teachers, vet them the best you can, but then build a platform where they can, you know, after giving a lesson, they can be rated, and the parents can give a comment, so they can start to build a reputation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So on the teacher side, they'll have a place where they not only can get jobs, but they can also have their own reputation. They can say, you know, I've been working for a year, usually my fees is 5,000 an hour, I have good ratings, I have 100 hours on this site, so this year I'm going to put it to 6,000 an hour.
Yeah.
You know? So it's a platform on the teachers, can provide value on the teacher side.
Okay.
But also same thing on the parents. The developer we're talking about opportunity. See the parents and students log in for account to be able to say, you know, my kid is studying today, after the study the teacher can give them marks. I can also build a place where the parents can put the students grade, the kids grade, you know, they get their certificate to the grade, so they know each semester how he evaluates, you know. So at least give value on both sides.
No, I got you.
That was, for me, that's the first thing.
Okay.
Just to make sure that the demand create a platform which you can monitor and, you know, centralize everything. And I was thinking, on the side of profitability, if you can just charge a commission after each transaction,
yeah,
that by itself can be, you know, profit.
Yeah,
if the marketplace or the platform, you know, delivers. Mm. But then that was the first thing, you have to make sure that the way people learn will start by that, but it's already there.
Yeah.
But then the second step is to provide online an online course. You know, take those teachers or take any individual who has a skill, who has something to teach, to be able to create a course and sell it on that platform. So they say if you want to get into entrepreneurship. I thought about you listened to after we talked, I was like, everything you say, that content you say, you can form an online course about entrepreneurship, about starting a business in Rwanda or in Africa.
Yeah.
Get together with somebody, have something really detailed for probably a course of like 5 to 6 hours.
Yeah.
You put it on there and then you sell it repeatedly. Digital products, you have to make it one time.
Yeah.
And then you can just multiply.
Yeah.
So I would start with the tutoring, but for me the main focus is set a platform where people can teach. If you have a skill, you have knowledge, you have experience, you can create a course to teach or meet one-on-one.
So I truly believe it's a needed product. I have a son, he's a year and a half now.
Okay.
So I definitely know I want to do tutoring. Mm-hmm. Or even homeschool, you know, type of services.
Actually, is that even allowed to homeschool?
Well, there's no law against it. There's no law against it. I mean, it's your child, so you have to do what you want to do with your child. But I know some parents that do homeschool.
Really?
Yeah. I'm a firm believer in the beginning. I mean, you know, everybody has their own I was talking to my wife about this, so it's very interesting when I saw your profile. But what are the challenges you have? Because again, now tutoring, I know there is existing solutions in the States for them, senior. Mm-hmm. So are you said
there are existing solutions? Like similar platforms or?
I never say similar platform, because every platform has their own ingredient, has their own modules when you get to the specific. But when I'm talking about this existing platform, there's a tutoring platform that exists in the States.
Yeah.
They call it tutoring platform.
Yeah.
And I remember because they were growing big when I left about a few years ago.
Yeah.
So the reason why I'm telling you this is because, number one, have you researched, not in the States, but in Africa, a similar platform?
Yeah, of course.
You did a research?
Yeah.
And did you find any similar?
South Africa, Nigeria, and India. Usually those are the three countries that have something lifestyle.
So
if I have an idea, I first check around there. So we can check out this skill up for South Africa. It's really doing big things. It's been around
over there
4 years. Yeah. And it's,
so you check it, you went inside, you logged in.
The whole process, I created an account,
so you looked at
all the process,
Because
Jerry is the one that has many of them, the whole system.
Because the reason why I'm asking, you said that you're hiring a software developer.
Mm-hmm.
Anytime you build something from scratch,
It's expensive.
Of course.
Yeah.
It's very expensive. Mm-hmm. People see software, now this tutoring, just like Uber, just like any platform that bring
two sides
entity together, requires a lot of smart system.
Mm-hmm.
Now they're using AI, because you have to make sure the system match perfectly.
The two parties,
algorithm and all.
Yeah.
Those are expensive.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know what are the challenges you have, but if you have to be aware of the investment you're willing to.
Oh, no, of course. Yeah, the investment I can already. I already found a developer. That was the first challenge I had, find a developer. And I found a Ugandan developer who did a similar e-learning platform, not tutoring, but have teachers uploading content and materials
past tests, yeah, exercises, and have a teacher on one, students on one side purchasing it. Mm-hmm. But he have a sort of like a subscription model. No, it's not for just to subscribe to the site and then select content. Because tutoring in Uganda is prohibited. So he can't have.
Tutoring is illegal.
It's
illegal. I have no idea.
No, he's too shocked. He was like, the government's reason for doing so is that the kids need to rest. You know?
So after school.
Yeah. See, kids learn in school and then that's it. No tutoring after. So even if you do tutoring, it's really illegal. They still do it, but not.
Yeah, you can't control that.
Yeah. So he can really create a similar platform providing that service. So for him,
that's interesting.
I've been on this for quite almost like 5 months now.
5 months.
Yeah.
That's still and
it's still early.
Yeah.
But during those 5 months, I was working with different developers, and none of them came to work.
Yeah.
And when I found him, he talked and he said, "Listen, so we need to build this plan to these modules.
Okay.
Most of the things you want, I already have. I'm not going to be building this from scratch.
Ah,
I'm only going to take what I have,
okay,
and then I'm just going to tailor it to your needs." So for me, that was one of the biggest breaks that I had. And the second was finding a proper business analyst who has knowledge in e-commerce and really can get down and not give you that generic, you know, business plan, like 30, 50 million, you know, something really tailored to a startup, because I want to start up in a bootstrap, you know.
Yeah, of course.
Just minimizing the costs. So for now, for me, that's...
For that, I can recommend you, before I forget, let me, there's a consultancy. They help you, and they have an office here too also, so that would be a good idea. They're based in London.
Mm-hmm.
It's a huge consultancy. Check first their profile.
They have an office here?
They have an office here, they just opened not long ago,
mm-hmm,
and they have an office in Uganda. So their job is very simple. They bring expert in specific needs you have,
mm-hmm,
from anywhere,
okay,
the West or here, I mean when I say here, Africa.
Mm-hmm.
So you tell them, so when you're part of their structure, the programs, you tell them exactly what you're looking for and they bring in an expert.
Okay.
That expert help you for free.
Really?
For always growth movement. Let me ask you, what's the contact to you? Because the one I have is in...
It's just called Growth Movement?
That's the name of the... No, Growth Movement. They're not a fund. They match consultants with startups.
Okay.
And they pay for that consultant,
mm,
for you.
There's requirements? Or you have to
They have to approve you on the program. So they look at how innovative your project is, which fall into the... Are impactful, exactly. So they look at a few criteria. But based on what you're telling me, there shouldn't be a problem for you to get in.
Yeah.
In the past. For software development and for structuring our group level.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got somebody else to help us structure a group level.
Okay.
So they're very good.
So they find somebody locally or somebody?
They find somebody based on the criteria. Because they try to find somebody locally, but sometimes they can't find that asset. Because the people that sign up with them, the consultants,
mm-hmm,
they sign up, they're free consultants. They want to help.
Mm-hmm.
They like, they want to give back. So they look at their pool of consultants to see who fit best for what you're trying to do. But check their website. As soon as I get their contact, I'll shoot you on Twitter.
Yeah.
It's called Growth Movement. So what are the challenges? Because obviously you came here
Definitely the challenges, the first one that comes, I think, is changes people's mind. First of all, to get people on the platform.
Yeah.
But before we get there, just the whole process. Because I thought about it, even though it's not illegal here, What's illegal here in tutoring is that a teacher cannot teach at his own school or school premises.
That's okay. One.
And two, you can't teach your own kids. So if you have a kid in class, you can tutor them after class.
Which is what?
Understand. So let's say you have a class, you know, you teach P1, and one of your students, the parents want you to tutor them after school.
Okay.
Your own.
That's what you said. The teacher on kids.
On students in class.
No, I got you. No, that makes sense.
It makes sense. The conflict of
No, that makes sense. Yeah.
So those are the two main rules.
Yeah.
And anything else, the government doesn't really get, you know,
I mean,
too much into that. But I will, after talking to a few teachers, the first of this platform is based on a teacher. So this is a teacher's platform.
Yeah.
Students. I mean, that will interfere with, you know, meaning doing Greg and all that stuff.
Okay.
And I want to avoid all that red tape. So that's what I want
to do. But you've talked to them, you've done research, I'm assuming in 5 months you've checked.
Yeah.
Did you talk to the teacher association? They have a huge teacher association.
I have a couple of teachers.
Those are individual. You need to approach them. I don't know the rules and laws, so I can't really comment on that because I don't. But as far as answering your question, as I said, you talked about mindset, platform, and that's a lot of mistakes startup make when it comes to digital platform. They think it's about building a platform and a customer comes. You're gonna have to have some marketing capital. You know, you have to market your product.
Yeah.
But I'm glad that you said that somebody, because I was gonna, the software developer already had those modules. Mm-hmm. So that's a good thing. Because what I was gonna tell you is check open source.
Yeah.
There's what we call open source software. We use a lot of those. Instead of building something from scratch, you take open source and you customize based on what you need. It's much, much cheaper now. You seem to have solved that issue. I don't know how you haven't tested and all those things, your system?
No, he still hasn't.
He's still working on it. Okay.
Yeah. Actually, no, he hasn't started yet.
Oh, he hasn't started yet.
Yeah, because I first wanted to find him. We had exchanges and he understood. He gave me a proposal in which that he hit every key point. Even the one we talked about, he's somebody who's really, I would say, very alert and very passionate about the ed tech, you know, industry.
Okay.
And he's got a whole team of developers who showed up before. So he's somebody who's right now developing another app called Mambo Pay, which he's about to partner with MTN. So he's somebody who's really, you know, he's done that, he's been there, he's got the experience, he's got the team. So at least I have him, and he already gave me the proposal. My second step was to find partners to help me find it. Because just like you said, this is going to be just the platform, but just, you know, the startup costs, the operational costs for, you know, 3-6 months. So I also got the partners.
So money, I've done a lot of video about capital. Mm-hmm. And I always tell people, for capital, right now, you're going to have to do competitions, you're going to have to, of course, that's the only, because there's no investors that's going to come in on just a product that has not been launched, that's not been proven to come. Because right now you need to find out your price point. Mm-hmm. That will be part of your pipeline, right? Mm-hmm. You're going to do a lot of legwork. So I would highly recommend you talk to the teacher associations, mm-hmm. right? Because you know in Rwanda, a lot of things are cooperative association. Yes. Mm-hmm. Because if they like what you're doing and they push, it'll be much easier for you to have a bigger pool on the teacher side. Right? Mm-hmm. And
they can even information.
Exactly. And they can share that information to their students and others. But of course, the first step you need to plan or strategize your pilot. The piloting. Because what you need to know is pricing. What you need to get is feedback. Right now you don't have that. What they like, what they don't like. Because right now you're building a product based on what you believe.
what you. I want to start with an MVP, just the minimum function, just to validate the idea.
I totally agree. Yeah. And that's a good point, because it'll be cheaper for you to, of course, to do so. But you need to gather data now. Your goal is to gather data. Is money the issue? Do you have a budget already?
For now, the partners, I've been able to gather partners.
Okay.
Who are willing to invest financially.
But do you have a budget for the pilot? Have you come up with a budget already?
For now, I'm working with a business. This is another issue that I have. We're to find a business analyst who can help me, you know, at least draw a map saying that, you know, the startup cost is this, we can anticipate this type of cost. Because when I sat down and trying to plan, there's the development phase,
yeah.
There's the research, you know, talking to all those teachers, getting them together, you know. And then, for me, those are the two main things that can come up
with. I highly recommend not to do this business analysis now. You need to do it yourself.
Okay.
A business analysis will, as a lot of time we hire some expert too early.
Yeah.
Where you steal, because they're gonna ask you data that you may not have. Mm-hmm. If they come up with an estimate and all, you're still gonna hire that person again later on when you have more accuracy.
Okay.
When you start something, you have to do everything as much as you can yourself.
Yourself. Yeah.
Because you have to fully understand your business. When you understand your business, then you can bring some component and guide them of what they need to be done. But if you don't understand your business, they're not gonna understand your business. They might give you wrong data or wrong analysis. The second thing is try to avoid hiring. There's a lot of tools out there that don't require you to hire. So there's a new, I don't know if you heard it, they're launching, there's a new accelerator. Are you doing this full time or you have a gig?
No, I'm about to do this full time.
You're about to?
Yeah. So I have a gig on the side, but I'm planning on running full time.
So my first advice to you is find an accelerator program. There's a new one starting in Rwanda from Germany, actually.
West one?
Yeah, I'll be speaking there. In a few weeks.
Mm-hmm.
You should, I don't know them, they just contacted me, but...
Yeah, I've been checking them out. They're giving like a free registration until the end of October.
They utilize that.
Yeah.
Utilize that. Because right now what you need to do is, it's a puzzle. When you start something, it's a puzzle. So this is just like
of
a puzzle.
Course, yeah.
Putting the pieces together.
Putting the pieces together.
Right? But with an accelerate program, for example, will give you access to those expert or analysis in their team for free because you're part of that network.
Really?
Yeah, that's what accelerate programs do. Mm-hmm. They help you build your business plan, they help you build your financial, they help you connect to investor. That's what a good accelerate program.
Yeah.
There's a lot of accelerate, but a good one. Mm-hmm. Westwell looks like a good one, but there's Inkomoko also. It's a good one. I've done that in the past.
Inkomoko actually have a meeting.
You have a meeting?
I contacted them also.
So do a quick search. It shouldn't take you more than a day or two. Find out how many accelerator programs they've run out. And talk to them. Talk to different ones. See what they offer to start. Because their job is to bring talent also. Because they get funding.
Think about Inkomoko is that they work with the companies that are already operating. That's what I gather from.
So you're not registered yet?
I registered, but I'm not.
When they say operating, it's a vague word. You can say, I've done research, this is what I've done, I'm working on a product. I mean, if they're looking for revenue, then that could be a little bit of a challenge, but then you need to speed up the process to get to that level.
Yeah.
But you're right, some companies need you, usually most companies just need you to be registered. Even if you don't have a product, you should be able to get it. I don't know, I haven't talked to Inkomoko, but it may be changed, but talk to Westwell. Do a search. I mean, I know there's a few here, but those are the two big ones I know coming in.
Yeah.
And when I say big, is they have funding behind. Mm-hmm. So sometimes they do training for you, they bring experts, they bring VC, venture capital, they bring all kind of tools that you can...
Also just the environment also.
Exactly, yeah. You know, they can tell you, you know, there's students out there that can help you on the software side for free and all. You can even hire an intern at some point. Mm-hmm. So I'll give you another tip. CMU, mm-hmm. Carnegie Mellon, right? Carnegie Mellon University.
Okay.
You know that they have an internship program for this student, which is not expensive. And those are very high-skill top students, because you have a partnership with them, and you have interns. And those interns they usually internship for 2 to 3 months, mm-hmm. and they can develop you a very detailed program, because they're doing a master program again. Meaning, when you get approved by CMU, it means you already have a track record of software. You know, experts that say, hey, this is what you need to market, to do the marketing, blah, blah, blah. Marketing also, partnership. So there is, for example, there's a lot of, we're partnering with Beka, for example, right now. But Beka and other companies, they have a payment system for teachers. No, for individuals to pay the school fees. I don't know if you, this
like part of that.
Actually, Nancy, what's your lady's friend? What's
Mariam.
Mariam, huh? What's the name of the company?
Academic Bridge.
Academic Bridge.
It's just that.
Do you know them?
No.
You should check them out. Academic Bridge.
Academic Bridge is of course RTUC up here.
Okay. What do they do?
It's a very big company. They do.
Go ahead.
Assisting. You know, like QuickBooks, for example, it runs accounting software. Mm-hmm. And for them, they have software that runs schools, mm-hmm. examinations, grades, but it's a connection between parents, teachers, students, mm-hmm. on one platform.
One platform.
Yeah, all over.
Okay. Mm-hmm. It's already operating.
Oh, they raised some capital. She's been doing this very, very smart CEO. She's been doing this for a while, grinding also.
Mm-hmm. It's called Academics what?
Bridge.
Academic Bridge. Okay. Just the way you get Academic Bridge.
Mm-hmm.
But as you said, you need to be aware of the ecosystem, because mm-hmm. you can partner with them, because they already have, for example, mm-hmm. schools in their network. Mm-hmm. They already have
the teachers.
They already have customers. Mm-hmm. They may have parents mm-hmm. in their platform. I don't know exactly. But I know, for example, Baker Tech House, they have a platform to payment for school fees. Mm-hmm. So if you're parents, you can pay school fees.
I've seen it, I think. It's new products.
You can talk to them also. Now, every time we talk to partnership, the challenge is they can try to do it themselves.
Of course, that's
what. But that's the risk that you should be willing to take. I always tell people, going back to competition, don't be scared of sharing your vision and all those things. You don't have to share the detail of how you plan to do marketing, how to do, no. But don't be scared, because again, if nobody knows you, nobody can come to you and say, oh, I need your service. So people tend to be scared of things, not sharing anything, and then they don't go and on. If competition will come regardless, whether you speak about it or you don't speak about it, competition will come. Especially after you do it, you become successful, you are sure competition is going to come.
Yeah.
So there is no way for you to stop competition. Mm-hmm. So you might as well, you know, the quicker you embrace that and understand that, the quicker you can be like, you know, forget about this, let me share, let me do this, yeah. let me do that without sharing too much detail. But talk to them. Even if they do so, Academic Bridge started first before Beka. When Beka came, they had to pivot a little bit. Because Beka is a big yeah, they have resources and all. But again, the idea you have today, I guarantee, the idea you have today will not be the idea you're going to have a year or 2 years from now.
That's for sure.
It will pivot, it will change. Mm-hmm. The more you learn, the more opportunity you're going to see, the more
challenges,
the more ecosystem. Customer may come and tell you something that you never heard of, that they may need, that you can incorporate it. So don't worry about being copied.
Yeah.
As long as you know that you keep innovating, you never stop innovating, coming up with new ideas and all these things. That's really what the key is. When I started this business here, it's not what it is today.
No.
It's totally different.
How long have you been in it?
5 years.
5 years.
So, you know, the initial idea is not what it is. Mm. But you pivot, you see what the market needs, yeah, and all those things. So, it's not me or anybody else. I've learned from the market. As for me, I incorporate. I don't limit myself. You know, but you could do the same thing. But right now, your job is to put the value chain together.
Yeah.
You need to understand the whole value chain. Because your brain needs to understand the whole picture so you can come up with solutions for all that.
Yes.
And so, but try to maximize you for doing all those things.
Yeah.
It's dangerous when you outsource so early on without you understanding maybe what that direction you're trying to go.
Because one of the main challenges I had is just, you know, when somebody does a business plan, sometimes things look a lot clearer. They say, for example, for the last five to six months, I've been gathering a lot of research, but now I have too much. Just trying to, because sometimes you get ahead of yourself, like, you know, you always take articles, read ebooks, you know, go to YouTube and Google, because that YouTube's got everything, you know, professionals, and you end up having all this data, and then once you're trying to go back and, you know, trying to sort them out, sometimes it's just overwhelming.
It is.
And it's just like, at first the reason why I was looking for a business analyst is to help me kind of just, you know, create a roadmap or just...
But that person is not starting the business, right? It's not even that. You're the leader of your company. You're the leader of that vision, right? That business analysis is just doing a job.
Yeah.
Right? So they're going to ask you questions, and they're gonna go to a direction that you give them, regardless. People think outside the help can help them, guys. It's not true. Because that's not really what their job is. Their job is to gather the information you give them, and they come up with it. So they're still going to ask you questions. So you're going to find yourself like, well, what do I need this guy for? Because he's asking me questions that I want him to tell me.
Yeah.
That's the mistake I also made. You know, I used to bring consultants. I can't tell you how much money I wasted on consultants.
Yeah.
You know, oh, yeah, maybe they know, but they don't.
Mm.
They don't. They just have big titles, big names for
fancy names, fancy terms.
Yeah, but they don't. And it's not that they don't know their job. They're very good at their job. But you asking them questions that they may not know. You ask them, who the business are, what you think we should do. No, it doesn't work like that. They come to you and they ask you a bunch of questions. And if you don't know the answer, then they can't move forward. So you're going to find yourself that actually you the one that have to lead the pack. So might as well do it yourself. Now, when you have a structure, when you know your value chain and all those things, then you can bring somebody to tune it up. That's what a consultant should do. Tune up based on what you already have started that is factual and on the ground.
Then, all that was business model, canvas, already done all that. To start with, like, in this value chain, what's the key, the most important part?
Well, I mean, obviously, what you should focus on, I don't want to say, obviously, your software is what you're,
of course,
you're but the core, they're all important, man. In the beginning, everything is important. Because, again, what you're trying to do right now is to prove this business case. Not just to prove, because it's been proven outside, but to find out what's the business case for one. What is the model for one? And I can tell you, you don't need to have a software. Have you talked to customers already? Have you gathered data? For example, what I would do if I were you is going to create a one-page market research data collection. Do you use Tutor? Yes or no? If you do, how much do you pay for it? If you don't, would you be interested in the Tutor? How much would you pay for that Tutor? Right? What value do you see in Tutor? What are the course that you'd be interested in Tutor? You can do that without a software. You don't need a software to do those things. You know, you can go and do a poll of 20 friends, family, whatever. You know, 20, 50 people, and you do it, you gather that data. You know, a lot of time, research is very important online. But the mistake people make is they don't go on the ground.
No, for me, I like
like talking to teachers, it opened my mind to so many others.
But don't wait to have the software ready to do those things. You can gather information and all those things. Because again, when the software comes, you already have some data to start with. Right now, like you said, you've got a lot of information. You need to streamline what direction you're going to take. Market research is what's going to help you streamline. For example, you're not going to start with all kinds of different things. Based on your survey, you see math is a lot of people say math, for example. You start with one type of teacher, math teacher. Start small, as you said, and you start with math teacher and see. You gather information, what's the price for it? You start with that price. See how people resonate with that price.
So what you're saying, just I do one sheet and just collect that data.
Something simple.
Manually, face to face,
talk to people. Doesn't cost you a ton.
Yeah.
It's free. Mm-hmm. Move around, you ask for people. Right?
Yeah.
And you gather information. Because you don't, again, data is key.
Yeah.
Right? And you can gather data cheaply with this piece of paper. Mm-hmm. People wait to have all the ingredient ready before they do that. That's a mistake. Mm-hmm. You know, because you still have to do it.
Yeah.
And you don't want to shoot in the dark.
Mm-hmm.
Right? That's too expensive.
Yeah.
Start doing this, at least it will help you streamline and start, you know, because right now you need to know what are the most popular type of teacher that people want. Mm-hmm. Okay, so you can start with that kind of teaching. What are the price points? You need to know that, you know. And then those are, and I'm sure there's more. But another thing I would say, that's very important, because you told me you're already researching on different products out there in South Africa.
Yeah.
You need to study your competitor. Mm-hmm. Even though they're not in the market in Rwanda, they're still your competitor, you know, in a way.
Yeah.
Because they've gathered a lot of data already, you know, and there's different ways you can do it, right?
Mm-hmm.
What I used to do is, I used to go on YouTube to study my competitors, mm-hmm. back in the days. Not this business, my previous business. On YouTube, and I used to type their name. A lot of them have YouTube channel, have articles, video, and they share information.
Absolutely.
They share information. You take note of that information. You see, they tell you some of the models works. You know, you mentioned subscription, or pay as you go. I think here it'll be more pay as you go, but you get all the information and you decide. So you gather information yourself with that market research document. When you launch your pilot, that launch will tell you if you're right or wrong. Mm-hmm. There's nothing wrong to be wrong,
okay.
But there's something wrong if you don't know, if you don't do anything about fixing that wrong, yeah. Right? So, but you need to know what direction. Plus, it will help you for your brain to focus better.
Yeah.
Because if you have all this information, it creates doubts. You don't know what direction you're going, you start questioning yourself,
exactly.
And you start doubting yourself, and then it becomes very challenging. So do that, streamline, and make a decision. The quicker you make a decision, boom, and you stick to that decision. Don't worry about being right or wrong in the beginning. Just stick to it and just do it. Exactly. You know, because it's very easy to lose focus and start getting deflated and be like, oh, maybe that was a dumb idea. It's very easy, man. And then you start sabotaging yourself. I've seen it 40 times.
It
will
happen from time to time.
It does, yeah, exactly. And that's
sometimes the brain is overwhelmed.
Absolutely. They happen to all of us, me included. But the quicker you make a decision, the better you'll feel. Be like, okay, let me stick to that. You know, and work to it. But you have a lot of work to do, man. Accelerator program will definitely be one. Growth movement, as soon as you reply to me, I'll send it to you on your Twitter.
Okay.
And I'll send you my email so I can, well, actually, you can give me your email.
Yeah. Or even send it
to me. Yeah, send me on this one. It's quick. So I'll shoot you those contacts. Because minimizing your cost is a key. And then I will also, there's a lot of money. A lot of grants, a lot of competition on education, of course,
class. But also,
your handwriting, where's the money?
I don't know, I write like a doctor. It's kind of like a JC. Actually, we can even exchange, I can send it to you on Twitter.
Exchange numbers.
Okay, that would be easier.
So what I would do also right now, and I did a whole vlog about this, is just start searching for competition in that space, green education space.
Yeah.
There's a lot of money, especially platforms that bring education together. Of course, there is, and they'll list you the requirement. A lot of those competitions tell you if you have to be in business for how long, but most of them cater to startups. But education platforms are huge,
right?
There's even an event in a conference.
Oh, there is.
Here, actually. This time it's in Kigali, it's going to be, I think, on the 16th.
I mean, to me, listening to you, you seem to definitely be on the right direction. Right now, you just have to gather more data. You definitely got to gather more data. Come up with a market research questionnaire. If you don't know what else to ask, again, Google market research for a tutoring platform. For example, you can find a lot of questions. You know, Google, like you said, is
amazing. Friend.
You know, if you use it wisely, you can gather some very interesting information. And do all those pieces together, but accelerate program will be my first step, right? Yes.
Find it accelerate. To build that environment.
Yeah, because it can help you in a lot of ways for free, at no charge. Right now, as I said, you gotta cut the cost. CMU also, I don't know, you know, because I'm sure there's open source system. I'm not questioning the guy you want to hire.
The only reason why I hired that guy is because I couldn't find any reliable person. I've talked to at least three developers, and one of them is a big company. I don't want to mention names.
Yeah.
But when I reached out, they gave me a quotation around $2,000.
$2,000.
Do it. But then afterwards, I met a friend who was working there. He's like, listen, they're gonna outsource this.
Yeah.
You come, you pay, and then they're gonna outsource
it.
So I would advise you to someone else. So you see.
I mean, if you like that guy and like this thing, I mean, go ahead and do it. I mean, you seem to know already.
He's the only option that I have.
Okay.
It's already good. If I have somebody who can do it, who's local, who's on the ground, I prefer.
No, you don't. We do all of our development overseas. Two companies in Kenya, one in India, one in Germany, and another one now in South Africa.
Okay.
So I'm a big fan of outsourcing.
Okay. So that's how you've been able to.
You see the team, we're 16, and we operate in two countries, and we did last 217,000 transactions with 6 people.
Wow.
You know, I'm a big fan.
What other countries are you?
We're Uganda.
You're in Uganda.
Yeah. Okay. We're here. We're Uganda. We're adding a third one next year, but. I'm a big fan of small teams and outsource. Because number one, taxes are high.
Mm-hmm.
Not just in Rwanda, in the region.
Mm-hmm.
Taxes are high. You hire a full-time employee, 40% of that money goes to taxes.
Mm-hmm.
That money could be used to develop something else in other states. Tax and labor laws are very tough.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you want to develop, people tend to, and even people raise a lot of money, they have to keep raising money all the time because they have to staff of 50 people of engineers and all. They have to pay top, they have to keep them busy, they have to make sure the salary are paid. I don't believe in that. I believe in outsource. Now, they have challenges in outsource, don't get me wrong. But the benefits are much higher, the downplay of the outsourcing. So I'm a total believer. Focus on your core business. Your job should be the fund, your customer, the teacher. You should build a team just to do so. The product development and all that should be outsourced. Marketing material should be outsourced. Advertisement and all should be outsourced. Anything that you can outsource, please outsource. It will save you money. Small team
with clients
and focus on what's the core. The core is to build your customer base. right? So you build a team. Our core team is to monetize on the kiosk. Yeah. So the only thing we do here is to look for clients that wants to advertise or push content on the kiosk, or companies that wanna sell services to our clients. That's all we do. We don't do no development. Our accounting is outsourced. What else do we outsource? We partially outsource our marketing. Also, I mean, I'm a big fan of outsourcing.
Yeah.
It will minimize your stress. But it will minimize your stress also. Mm-hmm. Because the number one reason why a company fails, they run out of money. Mm-hmm. That's the number one reason why a company fails. They run out of money. Mm-hmm. Can't tell you how many people I talk to. I have to close out of money. Mm-hmm. And this is and not because they were irresponsible and all those things. That's my last part I want to mention. You need to start applying for competition and grants and all those things now. Regardless if you have a clear vision or not. Because it takes between 6 to 8 months for grants or competition to reply and tell you if you won or not. Right? Of course, it's time consuming in the beginning. But in the future, when you apply to 5 or 10, the application tends to be the same afterward. But in the beginning, it's a lot of work and all. You know, on the weekend you have to find some time. It takes on average 2 to 3 hours to do one competition form to fill out and all those things. That's why I say an accelerated program can also be good at your financial, designing a business plan for you, because sometimes they need those documentation. And instead of you developing all that, it's better to have an expert to do that for you. So you have to. So when you ask me what is important, they're all important. I will not rate one over the other, because then it'll trigger your mind to focus on one thing and not the other. But they're all important. All that is important. Then as you grow, you can streamline and outsource some of yourself. But in the beginning, you have to control your whole value. You have to design, develop, and control your whole value chain. You have to be part of all that. Because if you don't know where you're going, you can't find people to help you on the direction. It's not possible.
Yeah.
You have to be the one doing all those things first to understand clearly what direction you need. Then you can delegate to the different partners. You're going to say, hey, this is where we're going. Why? Because I've gathered data, I've talked to people, I know, I've done research and all this. It seems like it's a lot of work, and it is. But it's necessary.
It's necessary
for you to move forward. Yeah. You can't do it if you work together. Because, if you're missing components, the consequence can be really dramatic in the long run. But I'll do all those things, but there's a platform called VC4, I talk also about it. I don't know if you checked the video, but VC4A.com.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that the one you talked about your last post?
Yeah.
About finding
grants and grants. So if you look at the whole video, I give you a lot of tools to look for fun, right? And the keywords to use and all. Mm-hmm. I think it's a 20-30 minute video on the YouTube.
It's called VC?
VC4A.com. And I will highly recommend to sign up on their platform. It's free. They also can connect you to investor in the long run. But they also have a list of different competition in that particular month or future competition. And you just have to go through it and see which one fits into your industry. And if it fits, you apply and all those things. But I will highly recommend you do all those things as important. And just close your eyes, meaning don't expect any return for the next 6 to 12 months. Now it's about strategizing and execution. You're not going to see result until later on. What I mean by result, you're not going to see real results. Like networking aside, monetization aside. But when you do all those things, then you got to sit down yourself with the research and all that, then decide what direction to take. And then from there, you can start building the website. By that time, the software should be at least, the basic module should be done. Then you can know what direction.
The website and have an application, an app.
But you need a back-end software to collect all this data. Is he building that for you also?
Yeah, no, he's been the back-end, where we're going to collect all those data, we're going to have to, you know, change.
Yeah,
he's going to build that.
Okay.
Because that data is very crucial.
All right.
You know, not only for the company, but I was also thinking about long-term, that can also be turned into a product, you know?
No, of course,
So it was very important. That's one of the first things that we talked about.
Yeah.
Even at the beginning, just to see how the site functions, you know, see how many visitors, what people like, what they don't like, see how long they spend on the site. So all those data.
Another thing that I didn't mention, the way I used to do also, that's a trick I used to find funding. I used to go to competitor website. Most websites, even mine, have a section for funding that we raise, whether it's grants, competition, and all. And I used to go and see what other organizations.
And then you go after that.
Exactly.
Okay.
So that would be
that's smart.
You know.
Okay.
So I used to do that and write their names and website and all, and then contact them.
Okay.
You know, and see if they have existing grants and all. And then apply for that and all. And I got a few grants like that. I mean, competition like that.
Yeah.
It helps make the process much quicker than going on Google and searching. So you go to those different websites and see on the funding side where they are. So that could be very interesting for you. But study your competition is really important. But listen, you're in the right direction, bro. You just need to execute a lot more.
Yeah.
Streamline better your research, cater to the London market, because like you said, most of the research you've done is more on a macro level. Now you need to do research locally and all that, talk to the different stakeholders that I mentioned. You can talk to them now or after you have a product, but that's up to you.
You also talk to Minitip, or that's just not?
Minitip is not going to help you. What you need to do is talk to the comparatives. Minitip is just the entity that controls all these things.
I don't want to start a product that I need to be in that. Sometimes they can say, you know what, you need to start this because it's intervening.
Oh,
that's why I wanted to stay away from the teachers. I wanted to be.
I think who regulates apps is RURA, not the Ministry of Education. Any app that you develop in Rwanda has to be approved by RURA. Our app also has to be approved by RURA. They gotta do, but those are not hard to do. But you can talk to RURA and see if there's any. But RDB or RURA are the ones that determine this tech stuff.
Mm-hmm.
RURA is more on the not safety, but security. Security backend. Because if you're collecting data of citizens of Rwanda, you have to have very strong security. But if you start up, they're not that tough because I understand very small data. You're still trying stuff and all those things. So I wasn't too worried about that, but if you want to know if your product is legal, I would ask RDB, because they don't want to issue license to do business. So RDB would be the right, because they have all the departments, you know, whether it's education, all the departments. So those are the guys I'm talking. But as far as, but I'll definitely get a hold of the cooperatives of teachers. They could be interested in that stuff.
Yeah.
Mm. Giving income to their teachers.
Hold on, I talked to a few. One of them suggested to talk to them, but once I have something concrete.
No, because
all the teachers I talked to, they couldn't believe. They was like, this is exactly what we needed. This will solve so many problems that we currently have. You know.
But if you have an MOU with the cooperatives.
MOU,
Memorandum of Understanding.
Okay.
It's not an agreement, it's just to say that when you're ready, we'll be working together, and that's the framework we're going to be working on. Because those things take a long time anyway to sign up. You know, don't wait. Anytime you wait for this to be done, then you do this, it'll take you forever.
Of course.
It'll take you forever. Because those guys here, for them to sign them, well, you might take a whole year.
Yeah.
Because, you know, they have to make sure it's according to plan, they have to talk to the ministry or whatever. I don't know their process. We sign an MOU with every district. Us, because we have kiosk in every new district you go to the district level, negotiate an MOU, tell them what we're doing, how it's going to impact your district, creating jobs and all those things. To bring them on board takes months. Talking, negotiation, blah, 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 back and forth. How are we going to help you? But when you have an MOU, it's almost like money to the investor. Like, hey, these guys won't work with me.
Wow.
It means that when your product is ready, you have a pool of teachers ready to be promoted. It's almost like money. You know, documentation, when you talk to investors, when you deal with, you know, grants, competition and all, if you don't have revenue, you have to show that you're going to have revenue. And to show that you're going to have revenue, MOUs, agreements, blah, 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 partnership, are just like money, you know? Just like money. You know, you can trade that for currency, literally for currency.
Yeah.
You see companies that they have very low revenue, but they have huge licensing paperwork, and they are treating like paper, like money. So don't do all those things at the same time. That's my advice. Don't wait. First of all, your product will never be perfect anyway. You'll have glitches, problems, issues, so it doesn't matter anyway. So you might as well tell them, the only thing you do have to be is registered.
Yeah.
That's the bare minimum. Now you can't talk to them if you're not registered. That's the first thing they could ask. But if you register, even if you don't have the product, the product is developing, it doesn't matter. You know, because also, you have an MOU with them, you're ahead of the game. Because always build a business like you have 10, 20 competitors already in the market. That's how I always do it. Even if you don't have them yet, always tell your mind, I have 10 competitors. How would I move? How would I do this? Then your mind works different. Now you want to hustle 24/7. Because you're programming yourself like you have competitors. Now you have no time to waste. Zero time to waste. Don't waste time. That's the killer of everything. You take too long, too stuff, your momentum will go down or something. It's very difficult to build your own momentum when you don't have revenue, you don't have any physical things to show and all those things. So the quicker you move, the better it is for you, for your business, and for everybody. So don't waste your time. When you doubt yourself, just close your mind, refocus yourself, keep going, you know? Because those are the killers. In the beginning, self is what kills business most.
Of course.
It's less.
Yeah.
It's
I went through a period where I was just like, you know what, I'm about to put in the time. But this is just too much.
It's tough, man. Is it your first business?
Oh, well, it's going to be my first tech business, my first big business. I started, you know, side hustles, you know.
But you know how. Yeah. It don't matter how small it is. Business is a mindset, right?
Yeah.
Whether it's small or big, it's a mindset. The problem is, I always ask that question because people that usually have jobs and start businesses bring that mindset of job into the business, right? And it doesn't work. You know, because job is structured, you know what to do, you work from 9 to 5, you okay, boom. And people bring that and they think it's the same thing, but it's a jungle. Business is a jungle. You have to, there's no timeline.
I know that.
Okay. So if you know that, now you have to hustle and everything. I mean, I think if you apply your hustle game and now speed up the process, because you can speed up this process.
Accelerator
should be done by me next week. Knowing which one, take it, talk to them if they approve you, blah, 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 blah. Already that should be done. Not the MOU, but already talking to the cooperatives and all that, you should be done already. You should start doing that now. You know, don't wait. Find out who's the leader in that association. If you don't know how to maneuver, I know a guy, Frank, his name. He runs a consultancy. What was the name of that? I forgot his name. So Young run this guy, well connected. His job is he knows how to maneuver in government and all those things, because he works with them also. So he's very good, very young, very aggressive, very hungry. I love him.
Good energy.
Yeah, very good energy. I really like the guy. If you find, kill me, I forget his
name. So he's like what, a facilitator?
No, he's a consultant.
He's a consultant.
So really, what he does as his consultancy, he started an accelerator program before people at the university level. People that want to start a business, but they don't know how, and all those things, you know. So he worked a lot with the Ministry of Youth, and all those things. So he knows how to talk to them. You know, our government, you have to know how to, they have a language, you have to know who makes a decision, and all those things. I mean, that does affect. It's not just Rwanda, it's all over the world. So, but he's good at that, right? But he does that on the side, because what he's doing is helping those kids. It's really his passion. He's really passionate about that. But he's what makes him money is really helping doing consulting. He's doing a conference right now. Man, he's gonna kill me when he. What's the name of this? When I have an issue, I always try to find who can help me in all those things. I don't believe in trying to do everything, because we have this way of now, if I share my ideas, don't copy. If I do this, I never understood that mindset. I really never. But I like connecting. There's a lot of talented young men and women doing some very interesting things in Rwanda, you know, that can help you, not just you, but can help, you know, they specialize in a way so you don't have to do all those things. You can start the step, but to close that, for example, that deal, you might incorporate him and say, okay, I'll pay you X amount, trying to find out, trying to push this case for me, or elaborate this case for me. You know, but he does also business planning for he's really good. He's a good contact to have. Just to network, to talk, not necessarily just for that job, but just to know. Just to know is really good. Frank, I've known him for years, man. Again, I love hustle.
He's a hustle.
He's a hustle. Guys,
but people even with that energy, just even by conversation.
Those are the people I enjoy. They don't find excuses. They know there's challenges, but they still go, keep going. You know, those are the type of guy.
He's young.
Yeah, he's a young guy. He's in his mid-20s.
Wow.
You know, he's straight out of college, started this. I met him. This guy used to train schools about how to write resumes, just on his own, started his own way, you know. And he invited me one time, I don't even know how he found me, he invited me one time to talk to one of the schools, and that's how we connected. You know, but you can feel his energy, you can feel the hustle, you can feel his passion, really passionate. So we always, because when you're down, and it's good to have those key people in your network, because you talk, they reboost you, boom, keep going. You know what I'm saying? That's the way it works. But he's a very good guy. I'm trying to think what's. I mean, let's stay in touch.
We'll be in touch. Yeah. Now, definitely this has been helpful.
You're on the right direction. You're on the right direction. Also send you an email, the contact for the movie. But yeah, hustle, man. Hustle. Achieve, the sooner you achieve those key steps, you know, because business is stone by stone, brick by brick. And you might not see the full, but you have to have the picture in your mind to keep focusing. But physically you might not see, you might be down because, you know, but you have built one wall of your house, you know. It's brick by brick, so you have to do those things, man. The sooner you do all those things, the better, you know, the closer you are. But check that accelerator program. They're just starting, I know they're looking for talent. And I've yet to see any platform like yours in Rwanda yet. So I think you're in a good position to get some interest.
That's what I've been researching here, is not yet. They might be coming.
They will.
Definitely not the only one with this idea.
They will be.
There's definitely young cast out
there. Don't say might. Always tell yourself that they're actually already there.
No. There's one that's already there.
Oh, there is?
Yeah. He's not operating, but
from the way I see it, he's developing something.
Oh, he is developing.
Yeah, so I'm keeping an eye out for
him.
Yeah.
You know,
my business, but competition is not, it doesn't scare me that much, you know, because it's all about, you know, the ambitions you have, the way you execute.
Exactly.
They can steal your idea, but, you know,
it's not going to shut you. They can steal your software, but they can't steal you. They can't duplicate you. It's not possible.
Yeah.
You're the driver of that business. Mm-hmm. They can copy everything around, but you. I always tell people, I'll tell you a funny story, man. Last year I was pitching to this investor. And
about a rent?
Yeah, that's the only thing I do now. I was, because last year we're fundraising. I mean, we fundraise every year now, but we're fundraising. So I was pitching, and it was interesting, I was going to put some money, but he wanted half the company. And we already had raised, so we had changed the valuation that we already raised. Anyway, long story short, I told him, yeah, that ain't gonna work. He's like, you know, I can do business, I can do it myself. I don't need you. And if it was me 50 years ago, I would have failed. I would have said, sorry, no, let's consider. Let's take the, not just disrespect, because my confidence 15, 20 years ago is not what it is today. Yeah. Now I understand that copying is not what makes a business. You know, it's the driver of that business that makes the business, right? So 20 years ago, I would have took that money, gave him half the company, thinking he knows better than I do. Now I know better, you know. And that's why I always tell people, don't, when you get to a certain level, you might encounter those type of things. Don't get intimidated by that stuff. No, never. You know, because they're not investing in the company in the first place, they're investing in you. You know, they might want to package it like they invest in the company. But really, investors invest in the people. They don't invest in the company.
Yeah.
Because the company is run by the people anyway, so yeah, those are the things, man. So
that's great.
But you're on the right track, bro.
So one last question.
Yeah.
If I do get into the accelerator,
yeah,
to be able to, because they told me it's gonna take about a month and a half to develop. If I do go with the accelerator,
yeah.
So what's the smart plan? To first start the research, really first understand. Or even develop?
No, you said it yourself, you're developing an MVP. So an MVP shouldn't be a big problem, because I'm assuming it will allow sign up, it will allow basic stuff, which you're going to need anyway. Mm. Customization should come after. Mm. Right? So get your MVP, absolutely. Get your MVP, do the research and all those things, do the accelerated program. As soon as the MVP is done, don't do marketing and all that yet. Get a pool of based on the research you've done, get a pool of teachers, get a small pool of customers that you can find, no more than 10, to test. Mm. Test.
Yeah.
And that's part of the pilot.
So we should already develop the MVP regardless.
You have to develop something. Mm. MVP is definitely what you need. Mm. You need a basic system. Because you need to have something at some point. So I wouldn't worry too much. Just make sure that MVP is yours. Mm-hmm. So you also have access to the source code. When you're a tech company, the IP, the intellectual property, is that source code, that technology. Mm-hmm. When you go raise money as a technology company, so that IP has a valuation. If you don't own that IP, if you don't own the source code that you're using, then you lose total value of your company. So that system has to be yours. But if it's yours, then you develop an MVP. And then from MVP, you can either continue with it, or like I said, bring an intern that you can bring, I can tweak it around, change it and all those things. Or if you see it as a good job, continue with that.
Because even just to develop it, that's what it's going to cost us. That's what charged me $2,000.
Just to do that.
To the developer, the website. That's what it's called.
So maybe for the website and the app?
No, for the website.
But what this website is going to be doing?
Exactly that. You can be able to. It's going to be the whole platform. You know, they're going to be able to register.
So you're not doing it on an app?
No, we're going to first start on the website.
Okay, I got you. So yeah. So it is your software on the. So it's not a website. It's a web application.
It's a web application.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's a web application.
Once we validate,
then we turn into.
Then we turn into.
Yeah, 2000. I mean, I don't know what's your timeline. I can always tell you what I will do, but that's just my opinion.
I don't. I time out to start or
to have this MVP, to have this product.
I would like to have this product by.
All right,
for me by the mid October.
$2,000 is for software development is not a lot of money.
It's not a lot. Okay, good.
It's definitely not a lot of money.
To start with is
really. But I don't know what exactly the components. But if it's a software that allows you to log in and all those things, and then you can have analytics on the back end and all, then it's definitely not a lot. It's definitely
not. It's basically Tommy will give you the full package. Like I'll give you something that function, of course, that have all the process in place, all the modules, the teachers can register, they can have all the payment system, the online payment system, the mobile money, all that can be.
The key thing to do when you do software development or any development, always build your payment plan to milestones. A lot of software
development. That's what I liked about this guy.
So you broke it down.
He already gave me the.
So when you finish one step, you pay this.
Finish a step, and he also put. There's another website where you can follow live the progress of the.
Oh, the developer.
Of the developer.
Oh, okay.
So that's also
part of the. Yeah,
he gave me an app so you can say. So the client work with remotely, you can follow live every step that we do. And on this site, it says this week we do A, B, and C. After that,
maybe you should share. What's the name of the company?
No. His name is Charles Mohindo. Google. He's Uganda.
I don't know him.
Charles Mohindo. He's been out there since.
He does software development?
Yeah. He's won many prizes, been all over.
Charles
Mohindo.
Mohindo.
Yeah. Charles Mohindo.
I'll check him out.
Yeah, no, I was pretty impressed with the guy, serious. But the thing I like about him is just also maybe Ugandan people, they know how to sell themselves.
No, yeah.
Like they know how, you know. You talk to developers here, like it's like me begging them. I'm like, bro, I'm not here to.
And we don't know how they make money here because
exactly
you bring in money, they still give you a hard time.
But to find them, you know, you call them, like yo, please, man, it's me, please, I need you, you know. I'll pay you. Like wow, like these guys can you talk. Like he's been
crazy,
on,
though,
he's been on my ass nonstop. He's like, yo, let's get this thing rolling. Like,
no, but what you're saying is so fucking true, man.
Yeah, no, it's crazy.
Yeah, I don't. They don't value customers. So, nah, yeah, that's we tried also here. Yeah. Unfortunately, we do all of our development outside.
Yeah, no, I understand.
That's crazy, man. But yeah, man. I mean, you have some of the ingredient. You just have to hustle on the other ones. But I don't see you. You know, we can catch up in 30 days from now and can give me some update or if you want to stop by, let me know where you're at, you know, and
definitely
we can take it from there.
Because the thing is, I've gathered partners who are willing to invest, but they're all like, you know, before we spend all this money, because I told them, I was like, we can do the research and, you know, talk to teachers and have the research, but we can already have that website started.
Yeah, yeah,
you know, like,
yeah.
So it can be terrible.
Yeah.
But they don't understand that concept. They're like, no, let's find a business analyst first. They see the cost ahead. I'm like,
I mean, again, like I said, you know, not to say they don't know anything, but that's the mistake people do. They bring specialists too early. Mm-hmm. That's the wrong move. Wrong. Mm-hmm. You need to, we need software. No, that's the wrong move. Don't waste your money on that.
It's the risk.
Don't waste your money on that. Make sure you drive this and let them know. Yeah. But business analysis, you can get it through an accelerator program for free. Tell them that also. Mm-hmm. So focus on those things. Right now, save money for them. Mm-hmm.
save as much money as you can. There's tools out there that minimize your cost. Do competition, do accelerated program, finish your legal, your MVP.
You'll have to find an accelerator, and then I'm going to try to get the funds at least to get that platform developed.
Do that MVP. That'll give you something. And then the sooner you have, when you have a pilot, now you have a real deal. Now you have some real deal.
Yeah.
Even if you don't have money yet, you should do the platform for free. Mm. Don't charge people. Don't try to make money with people. It's no problem. Your goal is to make sure that they like the platform, they see value in the platform. You know. It's free.
But the money at the beginning, that's what we're trying to tackle. Because the problem I'm trying to tackle is that teachers, when they go to teach, they don't sign a contract. They might teach for a week and then get ripped out. But what I'm trying to
say, when I say no money, you charging. So they can't, they may be.
The platform for me is that a teacher, to be able to make that match, the parent will have to pay.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. You get a percentage of that payment,
right? That transaction.
That's what I mean. You shouldn't collect any percentage in the beginning. Just allow them to transact between them two, agree on the payment, don't make no
just
money.
To get that data.
To get that data, to get that knowledge of what they need.
The feedback.
The feedback, but also people can talk about what you did. Build that trust. Because people try to make money too fast, too quick. You know, don't do that. That's a mistake. This is a long-term goal.
Yeah.
Always have a long-term goal. Don't get lost into, man, I gotta take this. No. You lose that customer, you lose more than the customer.